date of June 2019, Boca Raton, Florida, inspecting a house. It's a concrete T-pile, tongue and groove seawall. The seawall shows a sharp angle towards the land side. We are at the far south panel. Panel is cracked and has imploded. There's some repairs attempted on it, but you can see how this part, the cap, was again very rudimentary attempted repair, also snapped here, and you can see the angle of the wall. There is a sheet piling footer, however the lower parts of the panel, like here, you can see it snapped, and this probably continues. We can't see because of growth, but you can see the crack coming back right here. So the lower quadrant of the wall is not, is being unhinged. You could see there were some repairs done later. And just to show how far the lean is, if I put my stainless rod in it, more or less plumb, let's see how much of it is leaned in. So almost 15 degrees. Maybe even more. Right here, same thing. See, there's a lower crack right at the base. Right where they poured this footer, they tried to put the footer to save the wall from butting out. So it did stop it from butting out, but the snap happened right on top of the footer line, which is right here. And you can see it right here, there's a crack. And it just, if it was, wall was jet cleaned properly, you would have seen this crack. It goes and it comes back here. You can see it right there. I cleaned a little bit to show where the crack is. And right here you can see the T-pile is snapped as well. The wall is unstable, and you can see the signs of erosion everywhere here. There's sand here, all coming back from the backside of the property, from the upland side. Unfortunately, this wall was not arrested in time and just kept on moving towards the land side. Right here you can see also somebody tried to attempt it. Repair it. You get here, same thing. There's a crack here, and there's also a diagonal crack right here that was attempted to be repaired. I don't know how much fill there's behind. Right here is a new section of a cap and king piles, two king piles and two batter piles, and you can see how the walls continued to sag even on the, after the cap was poured, because there's a crack that starts about there. There and continues for about 12 feet. Breaks, snaps the T-pile right there. T-pile is severed. And so this cap is basically separated from the wall. And you can see on the last panel, bordering with the next property, this is the last piling on this property, the last T-pile. And then this is a vertical wall. So you can see there's an extreme difference between the vertical wall of the neighbors and this wall. Cracks and damages. The dock was also healed because of the angle. There's some more sediment here on the bottom. And they just built another secondary frame and ignored the lower frame to make the dock, the new dock, plumb. The pilings are good on the dock, but everything else should be redone when the seawall is either replaced or cap and pin piles or tiebacks are put in the wall to arrest it in its place. This inspection was conducted by Simi Dive.